So we start our draping course with introduction. Introduction includes tools and materials that we will need for draping. So tools. First of all, the main equipment for us is this. This is what is called dress form or doll. Some people call it mannequin. So technically, professionally, it is called dress form. So the dress form has different sizes and also different shapes. This one is produced in China and it has certain proportion with which this proportion fits to Asian body type. So therefore it's very useful for Asian people, for Asian designers. So other dresses might have different proportions, European standards or other standards. So we will have all the draping exercises on this Asian one. So the dress form. You will need this, or this, or this. So this is what is called draping tape. Draping tape. You see these lines on the dress forms, right? These are draping tapes attached with pins here, and they are showing us the main lines that will be placed by you later with pins. These lines will guide you during the process of draping. Right, for this you will use draping tape, 3 millimeters. I recommend the black one. And the red one, the other color, we will use for style lines when we start working with design. So the red one for style lines, the black one for the guidelines. Here. This draping tape. This is very useful draping tape. This is good for style lines, not for guidelines. So I can, this draping tape has some adhesive on it. So, and I can simply glue, you see, I can glue it here on top. So, and therefore, you can have different style lines, different shapes, right, using this dress on. With time, it's actually moving, right, from the dress on because the adhesive is not so strong, so it's good for style lines only, not for these guidelines. Right, so draping tape. It has a few colors as well, so may buy the draping tape as well. So next, scissors. Scissors, light scissors, lightweight scissors with plastic handle for slashing, cutting fabric, etc. Right. So we will use measuring tape we will use for cutting the fabric, measuring our fabric pieces for draping, and also measuring different sizes here on the dress room if we need. That's the measuring tape. So you will need, of course, you will need pins. I have a box of pins here. And this is pin cushion. It's useful to have pin cushion as well, so you may place it on your hand, on your arm, here, with pins during the draping process. So, pin cushion. Right. The pins, you will see, these pins are very small. Right. However, you might also find different types with bigger head. Right. So these ones are better for draping. So next, you will need pencils. soft pencils. I have 2B, 2B type, and I have 5H type. Both pencils are soft pencils or sharp. You will need a razor, of course. Right. Pen. And you will need paper when you transfer your drape. When you finish your draping process, you will transfer your drape onto the paper to create paper patterns. For this, I'm using this paper is not special, it's just normal, quite thin paper. I'm using this paper for patterns. However, if you have chance, you should buy a special pattern paper with some grid lines or dots on it. This is better than this one. And for constructing, for making the bodice block, which you will do in the end of the exercise, you will need thicker paper or cardboard paper. For example, here you see this is what is called basic bodice block. These two, front and back, and also I have basic sleeve block here. Right, you see it's made of hard paper, so it's useful. I can use this one for creating a lot of designs. So you will need rulers, so straight ruler. I have plastic one, 50-60 centimeters you will need. Straight ruler. So I have a ruler which is called French ruler with a special curve here. So we will use it for creating curves on our patterns. And also I have the ruler with right angle, right, straight ruler, because I'm using this paper which doesn't have any grid lines or any dots special. It's not special, so I will use it to create 90 degree angle between the lines. Right? So rulers. This is the awl, right? You will use it for drilling the small holes on the basic block to indicate the end of the darts in most cases. Right. And also for the reason for the reason of indication of our darts and other special places, we need a notcher. Right? We need a notcher. So the notcher creates this kind of small cuts, right? To indicate, you see here, it indicates the dart, right? The start of the dart there, you know, the intake of the dart here, and also the dart on the waist. So, important tool. Right, this is about the tools, right? And of course you will need iron, right? Iron. And you will need, of course, you will need ironing board, right? Or ironing place for ironing your pieces of fabric. Before you start draping, you should iron every piece of fabric. It's very important, otherwise you will not have neat work. So, and the last tool, tracing wheel. So we use tracing wheel to transfer the lines from the drape onto the paper or from paper to paper. Right, so this is how it works. You just follow the line, right, follow, let's say you follow. And just follow the line. And it will be traced down on another layer of paper. So, and actually, back to the notcher, I will show how it works. So, small cuts, right? For indicating the position of the ducts or the position of the guidelines on the patterns. So this is about the tools. We finish with the tools.